you.
This video has been sponsored by Skillshare, but more on that later. Hey guys, I am super, super, super excited to announce our latest and one of our biggest Make It Real projects yet, the Power Loader from Aliens, hydraulically powered and able to lift thousands of pounds. If there is a mid-size 8 to 10 foot Megabot or BattleBots league, it would be a serious contender. It'll be able to flip and crush cars. You see, I've actually wanted to do this project ever since I started making videos for YouTube, but the budget and scale of it was just too big at the time.
After the exoskeleton's done, my next main project, which I really hope to do, is building the Exoloader suit from the Alien movies. It's quite a bit bigger of a project, and it would probably cost at least $5,000 to $10,000 in materials alone. I won't be doing that for a while, unless miraculously this channel becomes really big.
Though, I'm honestly not sure how I thought it would only cost $5,000 to $10,000. We've already spent that much just on one arm. Anyway, I mentioned the project again and again as the channel grew, in various interviews, comments on YouTube, and videos.
We're even planning on doing a power loader from the Aliens movie. And that would be able to flip the car, not just pick it up.
In fact, it was in this video that we met Bogdan for the first time. He was a fan of the original pneumatic exoskeleton that I built, and he actually built his own version during high school. Then, he volunteered for us that summer, and he's been working part-time with us ever since. He's now almost done college and convinced me to finally start the Power Loader project. And he's actually been doing a bunch of the design of the arm over the past year. So without further ado, let's take a look at the CAD and see how this is actually going to work. All right. So, how are we actually going to design the Power Loader from Aliens? Now, luckily, since the movie's been out for 33 years, it came out in 1986, there's actually a lot of reference material available online. So let's take a look at this fan-made Wikia of the P5000 powered work loader. And as you can see, we've got lots of pictures on here, some sketches and diagrams, and of course, they made a whole bunch of little toys. One of which I actually have right here. It's pretty cool. Can't really do that much, and it's a very basic model of the power loader. There's no hydraulic hoses or anything like that, and honestly, it's pretty fragile, unfortunately. But let's read a bit more about the power loader and how it actually works. So the really neat thing that I can really appreciate on this is they actually made a full working prop for the movie, as you can see right here. The funny thing was, it's a prop that's constructed around the stuntman who's actually moving the suit, and Sigourney Weaver is actually attached to the stuntman. The whole thing weighed about 600 pounds, it was made of fiberglass, PVC, and aluminum. None of the hydraulics worked, but the grippers did actually open and close, but the whole thing was actually kind of more like a marionette for the actual filming of the movie. And they also made a miniature for a bunch of the shots, including the wide-angle shots during the fight with the Queen. The next question I have is, if this movie's been out for 33 years and there's this much reference material online, why hasn't someone already built a power loader? Is it too complicated to engineer? Is it too expensive? Unfortunately, I think the real reason is it's just not very practical. A regular forklift is actually very good at what it does, and there's no real reason that you'd want kind of a clumsy suit like this to replace a forklift. But luckily, Hacksmith Entertainment here, we focus on building the projects that aren't commercially viable. Because we're not trying to make this to sell it. We're just trying to make it to see if we can. And because it's a freaking power loader. Who doesn't want a power loader? The question's back to, how are we actually going to design this? Like, it is quite the engineering feat. So, like what we do for most of our projects, we're going to go to GrabCAD. Now, GrabCAD is a community site that allows you to share 3D models of pretty much anything. Let's just take a look and see if we can find the power loader. So there's some construction equipment. Ah, look at that. So a guy named Dano Vinson actually uploaded a model of the power loader, which looks fairly accurate to the movie. That's pretty cool. He's done some renderings of it, and I think there's a video. So yeah, he's done actually a really good job modeling the power loader from the movie, and in whatever software he used, I don't think he's using SolidWorks, he was able to even do some dynamic movements like this to show how it would actually work. So why don't we open up this model in SolidWorks and see if we can use it as a reference for when we're designing the real thing. So here it is. That's pretty cool. Now, the unfortunate thing about this model is it's actually just a single body, which makes it really difficult to actually try and use this model for our design. So really what we're just going to be doing is using it as a reference for scale and general shape of the parts that we're trying to make. But to start, why don't we start removing the stuff that just doesn't work? The funny thing is, hydraulics are a very real thing, but they need to be used properly to actually work. So all these hoses, none of this realistic. So remember, a hydraulic hose is carrying high pressure hydraulic fluid, and having connection points like this just doesn't work. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go through the model and basically turn everything that we can't use whatsoever red. So now just, you know, paint the model red. All right, so there we go. So basically, as you can see, none of these hydraulic hose locations or fittings or connections are going to work for the real thing. So we're gonna have to definitely design that on our own. But what else will actually work and what won't work? So in the movie, it says it's actually a combination of a hydraulic system and electric motors. So apparently the hips here are electric motors, even though they have hydraulic hoses going to them. And there's also no way, like, how does this joint rotate? How does this joint rotate? It's either gotta be an electric motor or I'm not even sure. So we're gonna have to figure out how we're actually going to do that. But one of the biggest issues with this design is these big cylinders on the back. So we've got a joint here that basically allows the arm to rotate back and forth like this and up and down like this. But the way they show it being powered is with this one big hydraulic cylinder. And as you can see, it's mounted down at the back near the spine and then attaches there. That's only going to allow you to do one movement. You're not going to be able to isolate moving your arm forwards and back as well as up and down. So that's also something that we're going to have to change. So I'm gonna paint these red as well. All right, so there's that. So what will actually work on this design? Well, the bicep hydraulics actually will work. It's fixed to the shoulder, and then it pushes the elbow out, not unlike my original pneumatic exoskeleton that I built years ago. So that'll work. We can use the general shape and outline of the arm. There's a lot of cosmetic features that don't really matter that we can include to make sure it looks like a power loader. The question for the engineering standpoint is just, how are we actually going to make it work? Because like you saw in the actual movie, it was just a prop that was moved around using wires and movie magic. So to make an actual working power loader, we actually have to think a little bit and figure out how best to approach this. Now, because this is such a huge project, we're going to break it down and build individual pieces of the power loader at a time. So to start, we're going to build just the arm. So I'm actually going to just isolate just the arm, and then we can go from there. All right, so now that we have the arm isolated, how are we going to use this as a reference to actually design our version of the power loader? And the nice thing is in SolidWorks is you can do something called a face export to DXF. So basically I can select all these faces of this linkage that we'll call the bicep linkage. And if I right click on that, I can do export to DXF. And what we're left with is a perfect outline of the arm. Now, this is just about all that we can actually use from this reference model, just the general outside shape of some of the joints, try and keep it to make sure it looks like the actual power loader that you can see right here. Because mechanically, all the hydraulics and all the actual working features of the power loader, we're gonna have to design those from scratch. But this is at least save us a bit of time in making sure that it actually looks like the power loader. So I'm just gonna go ahead and save that. And what we can do is if we open it up, we can import it as a 2D sketch. Now just to show you how simple this is, we can select all these areas. Let's make it, I don't know, half an inch thick. And there you go. That's the rough shape of the bicep of the power loader arm. So the nice thing with that is now we can do any modifications we need to actually mount the real hydraulics and the joints and how all that's going to work. But at least having this model means we have a reference to look at to make sure we're on the same track, to make sure we're actually making it just like the actual one from Aliens. All right, let's start designing. There you have it. All right, just kidding. We've actually already designed the arm. And when I say we, I actually mean Bogdan. So Bogdan's been the main driving force behind actually making this project happen. He's really inspired by the power loader, and he designed all this, actually a good part of it, last year, before we had the funding or even the ability to build such a thing in-house. And ever since we got the plasma cutter from Elite Metal Tools, it was like, hey, we could actually make this now. So this past Christmas break, we started making it. For the next design, we will actually record it and show you guys how we actually did the 3D modeling. But for this, I'm just going to try and explain how we did the design. So if you can't wait for our future power loader videos and you want to start learning SOLIDWORKS right away, there are actually some awesome SOLIDWORKS tutorial classes available on Skillshare.com. One of the most common questions we get asked about our projects is, how do we learn how to do all this cool stuff? And the answer is simple. We're self-taught learners. We use the internet to our advantage to solve problems. It's amazing the kind of resources you can find, just like Skillshare.com. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in design, business, technology, and even lifestyle. Start 2019 outright with a premium membership that gives you unlimited access to take all the classes you want on skills you want to learn to achieve your 2019 goals. Want to learn how to design cool things in CAD like us? Like, I don't know, a power loader? We use SOLIDWORKS on a near daily basis, and you can learn how to use it too, right here on Skillshare.com. Or, if you're more interested in making videos like us, we use Adobe Premiere Pro, and we've learned tons of tricks from Jordy, who's another YouTuber and instructor on Skillshare.com. Skillshare Premium is super affordable, with an annual subscription costing less than $10 a month. Plus, the first 500 of my subscribers to use my link below will get 2 months absolutely free. Over 7 million other creators use Skillshare, so what are you waiting for? So, for the next design, we will actually record it and show you guys how we actually did the 3D modeling to come up with the actual design that we then manufacture and fabricate. But for this, I'm just going to try and explain how we did the design. So first, I'm going to roll back some of the features inside of SOLIDWORKS. There. Look familiar? So we did have to modify it a little bit. As you can see, this mounting point for one of the cylinders was originally a lot lower, and we had to move it up here so we could actually get a proper range of motion for the whole arm, which you'll see here. That means that cylinder is actually going to be able to allow you to have the arm be able to go from a full curl to a straight arm like that. How we're actually going to fabricate it is kind of cool. So what Bogdan's done is he's designed a tab and slot system. So what that means is after we plasma cut the whole thing out, we'll actually be able to just almost like put it together like a normal puzzle. And then once it's clamped in place, we just have to weld those seams in and we'll be left with an extremely structural, very strong steel member. We've got some face plates here. And then the joints will actually be these big pipes right here. So moving on, let's take a look at the arm, or the forearm. Same idea. What happened was we originally exported a DXF of the outline of the reference model, and then we used that to make sure what we were designing is at least similar, so it ends up looking like the power loader. And again, we added some slots and tabs. And if you're curious about slot and tab design, it's great for plasma cutting as well as just laser cutting, which you'll be able to find at a local makerspace. And there's actually this really cool website I like, and it's called makercase.com. So what this does is if you select finger joints, you can actually say, I want to make a box that's 12 inches wide by 4 inches tall by 8 inches deep. And you say how thick the material is that you're going to be using for project, And if you go generate laser cutter plans, it actually exports the outline that you need to then put in your laser cutter and actually be able to make that box. And it's a really cool fabrication method that you can use with laser cutter to quickly fabricate project boxes. Because you wouldn't want to 3D print a giant box, because it would take forever. With a laser cutter, sometimes it takes less than a minute to laser cut all that stuff out. Bit of hot glue, bit of folding it around, and bam, you're left with a box. So basically, that's exactly what we've done on just a larger, more industrial scale for the power loader. Except our box is made out of steel, and we're actually going to be welding it shut. So next up, we have the wrist joint, which is kind of cool. And to solve the issue of being able to have a wrist that can actually go like this, Bogdan decided to mount another hydraulic cylinder on the side of the arm. Now, this is not how they did it in the movie, but it's probably the best way that we can actually do it. So as you can see, this cylinder, when it extends, will actually allow you to move the wrist 90 degrees in total, from one way to the other way. And then the part that we haven't quite touched yet is actually the wrist. How are we going to get the wrist to actually spin like this? There's a few methods. We could either try and build something like this hydraulic cylinder, or we could potentially have a hydraulic motor with a gear around this entire plate that allows it to rotate. And the cool thing with that is if we do that, we could potentially have infinite rotations. We could just keep spinning it. Because once this thing's done, we're gonna be wanting to add different attachments, like say, maybe a BioShock Big Daddy drill, which could just continually spin, and we could do all kinds of cool stuff like that. So anyways, like I said, this CAD design was already done over actually the past year. So we weren't able to record it and show you the actual process of doing that. But for future designs, we will be showing you the actual CAD process. But what this means is we can start fabricating the arm. So let's start building.
But the steel weighs 600 pounds. There's only two of us here. So hopefully we don't die. We did it! So right now we're exporting all the remaining DXFs for the 3/8 steel, and then we'll be able to start welding!
Alright, while we finish plasma cutting the rest of the parts for the power loader's first arm, make sure you smash that subscribe button and turn notifications on, because this is a video series you do not want to miss. We'll be trying to release one video per month on the series, while still making our regular Make It Real content. It'll just be like the days of the original exoskeleton where we posted a bunch of updates as the project evolved. Anyway, in the next video, we'll get the arm fully welded and built with hydraulics and do a quick test. But if you can't wait for that next video, make sure you follow us on social at The Hacksmith, as we'll be posting real-time project updates. Also, if you happen to be a YouTube channel member of The Hacksmith, it's that join button right next to subscribe. You'll actually have access to see video number 2 right now.
Do it. Do it now.